Hello, my name's Brady, and I've been using Photoshop for 25 years. It's been a long journey, but just a week ago, I got the program to do something I thought it was never gonna do. Check this out. All right, so in all seriousness, pretty cool, right? And I've got to admit, that was sped up, but not by much, because what we're actually going to do is build a one-button color bleed effect in Photoshop, and in real time, you'll just hit that button over and over and over again and watch the effect come to life. Ready to see how it works? Let's jump into Photoshop. All right, we'll get this thing up and running with a simple Photoshop document. This image is 1080 by 1080 pixels. This effect will work at any size, and as we go, I'll show you where you might want to adjust the settings if you're working at a higher resolution. And the main filter that's going to create this look is the displace filter. So displace takes your image, then references another image called a displacement map and creates distortions. So to use displace, the first thing we need to do is to create a new document, which will be the displacement map. I'll make this the same size as the original, 1080 by 1080. And here, this will just be a few steps. With this background layer selected, I'm going to make sure my colors are set to default by hitting D. And they need to be set to default black and white to get the right look from this filter, which is in the render section. I'm going to use clouds. Next, I'm going to use filter, noise, add noise. I'll set this to 10% and be sure it's set to Gaussian noise and monochromatic. Next, in the Fill and Adjustment Layers menu, I'm going to create a solid color layer, and in the pop-up, I'll set the B, or the brightness value, to 50%, making this 50% gray. I'll select the mask of this new solid color layer, then use Filter, Render, Clouds again, and finally, I'm going to do a levels adjustment using Command or Control L, and here I'll bring the black input level to 40 and the white input level to 150. Okay. So you should end up with something that looks about like that. The clouds filter creates slightly different clouds every time you use it, so you'll probably end up with different looking shapes, but that's fine. I do need to save this document. This will be my displacement map. I'll call this one color bleed map, and I actually just keep a folder full of these displacement maps for different projects. Then back in the main document, this first step is not mandatory, but this effect works much, much better if here in image mode, I set the document to 16-bit. I definitely recommend working at 16-bit for this effect. Then here's how it works. I'm going to apply a sequence of commands and filters, and this effect works by applying them over and over and over again. So an easy way to repeat things in Photoshop is to use an action. Here in Window, I'll make sure my Actions tab is visible. Then I'll hit the plus icon to create a new action. I'll call it Color Bleed, and I'm actually going to use this option to assign it a keyboard shortcut. I'll use the F5 key. You don't necessarily need to do that, but it is kind of a cool option. I'll hit record, and now the action is recording, and I'm going to apply a set of commands and filters. This is kind of like the launch sequence. It goes like this. I'll make a copy of the layer using the shortcut Command or Control J. Then in the effects menu, I'm going to apply a drop shadow effect. Now it doesn't matter what any of these values are in the drop shadow, I just want to be sure the opacity is turned all the way to zero. I'll hit OK, then I'm going to right click on the layer and select Rasterize Layer Style. Next, I'll use Edit Fill, or the shortcut Shift F5 to fill. I'll set the contents to white and the mode to behind. Then I'm going to double click on the layer and rename it Color Bleed. I'll make a copy of that layer using Command or Control J. Then I'm going to apply Filter Other Minimum. I'll set the radius to 1 and this preserve value to roundness. Next, I'm going to apply Filter Other Maximum. Again, I'll set the radius to 1 and preserve to roundness. Then I'm going to use filter, distort, displace. I'll set these values to 5 and 0. I'll hit OK, then navigate to the color bleed map file we just created and select that for the displacement map. Then I'm going to use edit, fade, displace, or the shortcut Command or Control Shift F. I'll set the mode to darken and hit OK. Then I'm going to use that displace and fade a few more times, but change the displace values a little bit every time. So I'll select the displace filter again, and this time set the values to 0 and 5. I'll select that same file again, then edit fade, or Command or Control Shift F to fade, set it to darken. Then again with the displays filter, this time the values will be -5 and 0. Select the same file, then fade again, set it to darken. One more displace. Finally, this will be 0 and -5. Same file, fade, set it to darken, and hit OK. Next, I'm going to use the filter in the sharpen section called unsharp mask. I'll set these values to 20% with a radius of 3 pixels and the threshold at 0. Then I'm going to use image adjust levels, or command or control L. And here I'll bring the black output level up to 30. Then I'm going to change this layer's blending mode to darken. I'll hold shift and select the next layer down, color bleed. Then use command or control E to merge those layers. Again, I'll change this layer's blending mode to darken. Then I'm going to double click on the layer and rename it color bleed. All right, I'm going to hit stop in the actions tab, and this thing is pretty much ready to go. I'm going to make one edit to this sequence in the action. The second item here, set layer styles of current layer, this is where we added that drop shadow onto the layer. I'm actually going to drag that item into the trash. The only reason for applying a drop shadow was so that we could include this rasterized layer style command, but now that it's in there, we actually don't need the drop shadow. All right, let's see if this thing works. I'm going to delete this layer we created while building this, and we'll just try it from scratch by selecting this type layer, and in the actions tab, I'm going to hit the play button. So you see a little bit of that effect, but each time I hit the play button, it's going to create the effect a little bit more. And since I assign the action to my F5 key, I can actually just use F5 to apply it. I don't even have to have the actions window open. I can just hit F5 and hit it a bunch of times in a row. It's actually pretty quick to apply those effects. It's just a matter of repeating it. And you can see it starts to max out and get these really light values near the edges after maybe about 30 applications. All right, well, let's put a few final details on it for a finished look. But first, if you're enjoying this tutorial so far, do me a quick favor and hit the like button. That just helps the video to get ranked on YouTube, so thank you for that. And I've always got new content on the way, so be sure to subscribe. It's all original techniques that you won't find anywhere else. All right, well, let's give this a little bit of texture. I'm gonna grab this rolled ink texture. This is a free high-res texture from texturelabs.org. I'll copy that, then paste it on top. And I'm going to set this layer to screen mode. I'll use Command or Control T to transform and scale it down, find a good spot for it. Then maybe I'll also use a levels adjustment here and bring up the black values, drag down the white values, and give this a little bit more clarity. All right. Well, if you guys have watched this channel, you know that I almost always end up creating a merged copy of the final image using that crazy shortcut Command Option Shift E or Control Alt Shift E. And make some final overall adjustments here. I'm going to use filter, camera raw filter, and here I can kind of just adjust things by eye. But I do think it looks kind of cool to drag the highlights value down, and that kind of brings out the edges of the ink. Maybe I'll bring the shadows up a little bit and the blacks down, and then use a little bit of sharpening to make the image a little bit more crisp. It's subtle, but that does give it a nice finished look. All right, well, now your color bleed effect is ready to go. It's as easy as hitting that F5 button with any layer selected. A couple of quick notes. If you want to make the color bleed effect more dramatic, or if you're working at a higher resolution and you need the bleeding edges to travel further, what you can do is crank up the values in that displace filter. So this was what it looks like with the displace set to 5. Here's what the effect looks like with all those displace values tripled at 15. Pretty crazy. Now, if you're applying the effect and you're ending up with colors bleeding in kind of a weird spot, or if you just want to modify the shapes it's creating, you can go back into this color bleed map file, and a quick way to change it up is to select this mask again on the solid gray layer and just render clouds again, giving you new shapes. Then use levels set to 40 and 150, save that file, and now when you apply the effect, you'll get colors bleeding in totally different spots. All right, definitely worth trying out this effect with photography or illustrations. And if you're curious how I got that negative effect at the beginning of the video, in this document, I've got the base layer, which is black and white, then an invert adjustment layer on top of it, which gives it a totally different look. There's also a gradient map adjustment layer to bring some color into it, and a couple of textures layered over the top. And the cool thing here is that even with all these adjustment layers and textures on top, I can still select this bottom layer and watch the effect come to life with all the colors inverted. All right, well, I hope there's someone out there who enjoys experimenting with this technique as much as I do. If so, please do hit that like button and let me know what you think in the comments section. Be sure to subscribe for more content on the way. Thank you to the texturelabs.org Patreon supporters, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.